Gorry Gorry here again, solicitor in Enfield and County Meath. One of the very most important things that you as an employer or as an employee needs to be very much aware of is whether when bringing a claim for any employment related issue, you really do need to prove, the very first thing you need to prove is that you were in fact an employee and not an independent contractor. There's a crucial significance in any employment related case, but particularly an unfair dismissal one. In most cases, this is quite clear, it's not a problem. There's a contract of employment in place. There's no argument between the parties that he or she was an employee, and that's it, the case will go ahead. However, if the employer can prove or show that the employee was in fact not an employee but an independent contractor, then it's game over. The claim is going nowhere, it'll be dismissed, and neither the court nor the Employment Appeals Tribunal or any other body has the authority or jurisdiction to hear the case because you must be an employee. You would think by now that the question of whether someone was an employee or not would be fairly clear cut. But that's not the case, and it really does depend on the circumstances of each particular case. In 2014, there was a High Court case involving a lady called Sabina Murphy, who took on Grand Circle Travel. Now, she lost her case, but central to the argument on both sides was the fact that the company argued that she was an independent contractor and that she had signed an agreement to that effect, and consequently she was not an employee and her claim could not be heard. The High Court then really decided that because she had conducted, perversely or paradoxically, she had conducted her case so well in the High Court, that her argument that she had been pressured or pressurised into signing an independent contractor agreement really didn't stand up. And consequently she was found to be an independent contractor, was not an employee, and her case simply could not proceed and could not be heard. So if you're an employer, it's a great defence for you to have. If you're an employee, the very first proof you need to be concerned about, and it may not arise in most cases, but the very first proof you need to be concerned about is that you were in fact an employee. This is not an academic argument or a sort of a legal argument for anorexia. It's a very, very serious question that has to be proven at the outset of any employment-related case. I'm Terry Gorry, and I'm a solicitor in Enfield, and you can pick up a free booklet that I give out, a free report on my website, employmentrightsireland.com. It points out 16 sort of common mistakes that cost Irish employers money. Thanks.